Good morning, Washington Middle School. Good morning.
Good morning.
Come on, I know it's Monday morning and we can do better than that. Good morning, Washington Middle School.
Good morning.
That sounds like Washington. Wow. What a great day to be a Wildcat. What a great day to be a Washington Middle School student, staff member, parent. Wow, what a great day. We're here celebrating 27 years of Red Ribbon Week. And on behalf of the Washington Middle School students and staff, I'd like to welcome all of our guests, welcome all of our distinguished guests. Will you just please stand so we can give you a round of applause? Let's welcome our guests here. Thank you. Our master of ceremony, the Honorable Judge Jason Russell, will introduce each and every one of our distinguished guests, but I'm excited. I don't want to take up too much time. I'm ready to get the program started. So without further ado, I would like to introduce our master of ceremony, the Honorable Judge Jason Russell.
Good morning, Washington Middle School. Can you all hear me? All right.
Which one do you want me to use? All right, I'll try this one then. There we go. Good morning. I'd like us all to, before we begin today, to stand, and I'm going to invite the Slogan Award winner, John Monet Riley, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So if you would all please stand.
What's up? Let's say the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, John Monet. I would like to thank you all for being here to celebrate Red Ribbon Week, which stands for the slogan that to be drug-free, it takes a community. I'd like to thank everyone for being here. I will introduce the various people who will come to speak as they come up. But before so, I would like to thank the school board president, Tamara Coleman, for being here today. I saw her a bit earlier, but Dr. Ormseth, the assistant superintendent for school leadership for secondary schools, is also here with us today. As we begin today, I'd like to invite our first speaker, Dr. Sue Savaglio-Jarvis, the superintendent of schools, who will share with us a few remarks. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge. Thank you all for allowing me to speak before you this wonderful morning. And those of you who don't know, I am a student of Kenosha Unified. I do remember sitting in seats just like you, listening to numerous people. So I appreciate you letting me come back and share my story. Good morning, and today we're here to celebrate the 27th year of Red Ribbon Campaign. This week is dedicated to events that educate and encourage students and families to have courageous conversations about making good decisions, staying strong, and staying healthy. As a former physical education teacher, health is extremely important to me, and one huge factor in staying healthy is staying drug-free. There are a great number of events that are planned for this week to help get the conversations about making the right decisions started, and I sincerely hope that you will take the time to participate and learn from what is shared. Again, I'm so very proud to be standing in front of you here at Washington Middle School, where not only this year's slogan was developed, but also the award-winning poster. What an accomplishment. Please join me in giving a round of applause to John Monet and Tessa for their brilliant work. Tessa? This tells me that students at Washington Middle School are cognizant of the dangers of drugs and dedicated to drug prevention in our community. By embracing the slogan, "To be drug-free takes a whole community," you as students can help make a difference in Kenosha by standing up to those who peer pressure others and encouraging family and friends to say no. You are making our community a better place. It is my hope and wish for each one of you to be healthy. In order to be healthy, one has to maintain a healthy lifestyle by making those positive choices. These positive choices will lead you on a path of success. You see, greatness is for every one of you. Is it achieved every day by you and your commitment to learning and living a life? It is a combination of doing what is right, making the right choices all the time, having the right motivation for your life, and keeping yourself going in the right direction. The possibilities are endless. Why is it important to be drug-free? You want to thrive in this world. You have so much to give in this life, and being drug-free will lead you to a longer and fuller life for which your dreams will be fulfilled. Do not settle for something like drugs to come between you or your dreams. Your dreams are important, your goals are important, and your life is important. You'll have more energy, clear thinking, and a stronger body so that your goals and dreams can be attained. Last one, it allows you to empower yourself to just be you. And while not letting others influence you, it allows you to be the leader over your choices and the leader of your life. I'd like to congratulate and thank the winners of this year's campaign and hope that all of you find it within yourselves to be a leader and stay drug-free. Thank you.
Well, as Dr. Sue said, let's get it started. Mr. Dickinson, if you'd have the band get it started then. was excellent. Thank you very much, Mr. Dickinson. That was great. With the theme that it takes a whole community, we've already heard from the school superintendent that's part of our community, and the men and women of law enforcement who help keep us safe as another member of our community. So I'd invite Sheriff David Beth to come up and give us a few remarks. I now have the pleasure of asking Chief John Morrissey from the Kenosha Police Department to share some remarks with us.
Thank you, Judge. My job is to make sure that everybody understands the message here. I've got quite a few remarks. They gave me an hour to talk this morning. Can you believe that? I'm going to be up here an hour. So I guess just bear with me. You know, to be drug-free takes the whole community is so true. And when you look up here at this row, you have your principal. He wouldn't be a principal if he wasn't drug-free. You have the mayor. He wouldn't be the mayor if he wasn't drug-free. You have the judge, who wouldn't be a judge or a lawyer if he wasn't drug-free. You have the young lady who wrote the slogan. You have the superintendent of schools. She wouldn't be the superintendent if she wasn't drug-free. You have the president of the school board. Wouldn't be president of the school board if she wasn't drug-free. You have the county executive, so he runs the county. Wouldn't be that without drug-free. And then you have the sheriff, and I think it was a crooked sheriff's deputy, not crooked police officers down in Mexico, but he wouldn't be the sheriff. I wouldn't be the chief. So the community is represented up here, but the community is much bigger than that. The community I serve is 100,000 people. The mayor's my boss, but I serve 100,000 people, and all of you guys in here are that. So my job is to make sure you understand the message of being drug-free. So I have a couple sayings that here's what I think you should tell people if they ask you to do drugs. So if you think taking drugs is not the thing to do, they're going to take over you. You may be kids, but from what I hear, your pledge to lead a drug-free life today is the day to start. When a friend says, "Do you want to get high?" tell that friend, "Bye-bye." You will not succeed in school if you think that drugs are cool. If someone says it's a way to be cool, you say back to them, "I think you're a fool." Remember, drinking isn't cool. It makes you act like a fool. And I can attest that's true. If someone asks you, "Do you want to smoke dope?" the simple answer is, "Nope." If you ask me, it's clear to see that drug-free is the way to be, and it takes the whole community. So you have to stay drug-free. Now, every year, since you're so honored to have the superintendent and the president of the school board here, they need to hear from you guys that you're going to be drug-free. So all the fifth graders, stand up quick. Sixth graders. Okay. There's just one word that I want you guys to yell out as loud as you can. And the answer, that word is no. So if somebody offers you drugs, what do you say?
No!
I don't think that was loud, was it, Dr. Sue? I don't think they heard you. Scream that word to them. Go ahead. What's the word?
No!
All right, you guys can sit down. Seventh graders, stand up. All right, now here's part of the test. This was the sixth graders. You guys are seventh graders, so you become leaders now because you have to take care of the sixth graders. So you heard them scream no. You guys need to show them how to scream no the right way. So everybody tell Dr. Sue and President Coleman, if somebody offers you drugs, what's the answer?
No!
I think that was pretty good. All right, eighth graders. All right, now, we gotta make sure we get this correct, because this is very important. I heard Dr. Sue say in her speech something about peer pressure. There is nothing that makes kids go to drugs more than peer pressure. Peer pressure is a terrible, terrible thing. So you eighth graders, please look over at the sixth and the seventh graders. You really are their inspiration. You guys are here to make sure that these guys follow the lead and don't do drugs. So you have to tell everybody up on this stage, what is that answer if somebody offers you drugs?
No.
All right, I'm gonna let you try one more time because I think Mr. Tolfrey was kind of embarrassed by the eighth grade class. So what's that answer?
No!
All right. I appreciate everybody doing that. And part of it is just to get you excited about Red Ribbon Week. Really, the answer is that simple. It's no. You say no to alcohol, no to drugs, no to tobacco, no to join a gang. And seriously, eighth graders, you are the leaders and the mentors of these sixth and seventh graders here, so please take care of them. We must keep ourselves drug-free. Thank you.
It is my understanding that the tickets to Action Territory will be drawn by the PST. PBIS team. There'll be an announcement later as to the winner of that. I would like to invite up, Tessa Keswich. They're going to draw it right now. Hold on. Please hold your tickets.
I'm going to take over the microphone.
Go ahead.
Humphrey, will you pick?
After you, sir.
Sorry, but wait, he's going to make an announcement.
We need a quiet so we can hear all the names that are going to be called. Again, you guys are doing a great job. Let's keep it up. Job continues. I think everyone in here should receive Wiley cash later on today. And the winner for the four tickets to Action Territory is Antonio Acevedo. Antonio, stand up. Where are you? Come on up. Come on up.
Got to see if this works in court with the attorneys. I think I'm going to try that. I'm glad I came here to Washington Middle School. I think I just learned something that I might be able to use. I'd like to invite then Tessa Kazarich up. She is our spring poster winner, student here at Washington Middle School, who will read for us "The Way I Am" by Jasmine Love.
Okay.
Say good morning.
Good morning.
There you go.
Okay. "The Way I Am" by Jasmine Love. "That's not for me, whatever you're offering. I know you're no good for me. I like myself just the way I am. So take all your drugs. You're wasting your time with me. I like myself just the way I am. I don't care what you say. Peer pressure me always. Your words are dead to me. I like myself just the way I am. Excuse me if I seem rude, but I'm telling you the truth. You're a negative influence that I just don't need, because I like myself just the way I am."
Really got to do that. I am very happy to introduce our next two presenters. As I look out amongst 6th, 7th, and 8th graders, I can't help but think there's school superintendents out there, there's teachers out there, there's principals out there, there may be some lawyers out there, some police officers, because the one thing about all these people up here who aren't students is we're getting older. And someday, we're not going to have these jobs. Someone sitting out there is. And staying drug-free is the first step to being up here. And so, I know County Executive Jim Cruiser is here to read for us a proclamation. And what that is for all of you is a statement of our county declaring something to be special. So. County Executive
Cruiser. Thank you. Thank you. Good morning, Washington Middle School. There you go. I'd like to thank Dr. Sabaglio for including me, and Principal Curtis, and all the staff, teachers that have helped make this possible today, and the work you do every day, all year long. And beautiful music, of course, by the band. It's a pleasure to be here today as county executive, and I'm glad to be back at Washington Middle School. Our community is like one of those blankets made out of patches, a patchwork quilt. Y'all know what that is?
Yeah,
all right. Kind of like a checkerboard, except it's a blanket. And when all the patches are strong and tied together, you have a strong, warm quilt, just like a community is a strong community. And when people take drugs or alcohol, that weakens the fabric of our community. And when somebody is on that, you need to get to an adult to have them get some help so they can get back on the track of being a productive young person, to go on and be all that you can be. What a marvelous, marvelous poem or writing that you just read. Oh my gosh, the reading was right on it. It was so real. I'm fine who I am. Go away. I'm going to dictate my own future. I'm not going to let a drug dictate my future. So all of you try to be the strong part of that fabric, that quilt called our community. And we'll have a stronger community every day in every way. With that, it's my pleasure to have John Monet and Tessa come up here. Where are you? Come on up here. Give it up for them. That's right. Give it up. Right here. I've got an executive proclamation for both of them. It's called Red Ribbon Campaign Week, October 19th to the 25th, 2014. Whereas alcohol and other drug abuse continues to grow in epidemic proportions in this nation, and it is essential that we continue to increase public awareness of the alcohol and other drug problems. And whereas it is imperative for our community to continue its visible, unified prevention education efforts to reduce and eliminate the demand for illegal drugs. And whereas the National Red Ribbon Campaign is celebrated across the nation to offer all citizens an opportunity to participate and demonstrate their commitment to drug-free, healthy lifestyles by wearing and displaying red ribbons during this campaign. We got one right here. And whereas this year's campaign slogan, created by John Monet Riley, to be drug-free takes a whole community, and the overall poster winner contest is Tessa Kosrich. Give it up for them again. Both are students representing Washington Middle School. Let's hear it for Washington Middle School. Now, therefore, be it known that I, Jim Cruiser, County Executive of Kenosha County, do hereby proclaim the week of October 19th to the 25th, 2014, as Red Ribbon Campaign Week. In and for the County of Kenosha, and invite and urge all citizens to take part in the drug prevention education activities and make a visible statement that we are strongly committed to a drug-free society. Signed by myself, Jim Cruiser, County Executive. Thank you.
Well done.
I'll now invite the Mayor, Keith Bosman, to share with us a proclamation from the city. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Judge, and thank you. It's an honor to be here today with such an enthusiastic group. You know, you're reading the paper every day about people who reach success in their lives, people like Melvin Gordon, people like Trey Waynes, people from Kenosha who've gone on and made a success of their lives, and then people who are sitting here on the stage who have made the right choices, who've gone on to be leaders in the community. But then you read about other people who end up in jail or they end up in the cemetery because they made the wrong choices. And you read about it every day. We have a lot of people here at Washington Middle School who are there to help you. Parents at home who are there to help you make the right choices, and it's very important to do that. You know, middle school, maybe your adulthood seems far away, but it's not. You know, time goes quickly, and the choices that you make here in middle school, in high school, will stick with you for the rest of your lives. Make the right choices. Could I have the girls back up? Tessa? John Bonet, I'm going to keep you going up and down here. I've got a proclamation here for the both of you. And it says, whereas safe and drug-free schools and communities programs and the Concerned Citizens Coalition are sponsoring a Red Ribbon Week here in Kenosha County. Whereas it is imperative that visible, unified prevention education efforts by community members be launched to reduce the demand for drugs. Whereas the National Federation of Parents for Drug-Free Youth and the Alliance for a Drug-Free Wisconsin are sponsoring the National Red Ribbon Campaign, offering citizens the opportunity to demonstrate their commitment to drug-free lifestyles. Whereas the entire county of Kenosha will demonstrate their commitment to drug-free, healthy lifestyles by celebrating Red Ribbon Week, using the slogan, "To be drug-free takes a whole community," developed by John Monet Riley. The overall poster contest winner is Tessa Cosridge, and both students attend school here at Washington Middle School. Now therefore, I, Keith Bosman, the mayor of the city of Kenosha, do hereby proclaim October 19 through 25, Red Ribbon Week. To be drug-free takes a whole community, and encourage all citizens of Kenosha to support drug prevention education activities, and commend the Concerned Citizens and the Kenosha Unified School District for their leadership efforts. And here we go, ladies.
So we've had the opportunity to hear from many parts of our community, from the superintendent, from law enforcement, from our elected leaders. But our community is not only that big, your community is right here, Washington Middle School. And I can't help but echo what Chief Morrissey said perfectly, which is, eighth graders, look back. They're looking to you. And seventh graders, guess what? 9 months from now, you're going to be over there. And these guys and people you don't even know in elementary school are going to be looking to you. And so it takes a whole community. You have the opportunity to make your dreams. Drugs just get in the way of it. So to close our remarks here today, I want to bring someone from your community up to speak to you. Ms. Allen is a guidance counselor here at Washington Middle School, and she'll conclude our program. Thank you.
Great job, students, today. I want to thank everybody up here for coming. Thank you for the band. Thank you guys. Thank teachers, students. You were all very well behaved. Thank you so much. This year, I'd like to wish you all luck in the new poster contest. The new slogan is "Being drug-free, oh, the possibilities." That starts up today. You will start your poster contest. Thank you so much for coming.